Alrighty. What's going on, everyone? Hope you've been enjoying Voltathon Sparked. I'm happy to bring Beautiful Joe, a cool little platforming game, 3D by Clover. Came out on GameCube, PS2. It's good stuff. Good stuff. So let's get started. This is any% kids, which is the difficulty. I know it's kind of weird looking at all this. This doesn't seem like difficulties, but they are. So let's get started. In 3, 2, 1, and go. All right. So Joe and Sylvia, I'll just kind of give you an idea of what the game's about. Joe and Sylvia go to the movies. Went to go see a superhero film about Captain Blue. And Sylvia gets sucked into the movie by these evildoers, and Joe has to go save his beloved Sylvia. So he jumps in the movie and has to fight all these villains and whatnot with some pretty cool superpowers. But we're just gonna start out as the average Joe for now. The superpowers will come with the time. We'll see. Sorry, here I'm going to try and manipulate these enemies by dodging either up or down, because there's no guarding in this game, it's just all dodging. If you get hit, you get hit, so. No guard. Oh my lord, okay. That was different. And as you can see, they get very dizzy, and when they're in this dizzied state, they're actually a lot more vulnerable and don't take too many hits to kill, as opposed to when they're not dizzy. Alright, here's our first encounter with Captain Blue. And that was a pretty good fight. Pretty solid. And he's gonna teach us slow-mo. So now that we're in slow-mo, we're able to do a lot more damage with each of our hits. It's just how it works. And also, for now, until we get a certain move, we're gonna be doing a bunch of uppercuts to get around, because it's the fastest form of movement. Or at least, I believe it is. And here's Joker, but he's dead already, pretty quick. And then slots. Each of these slots, it'll give you food, coins, or the V's will give you the key to progress to the next area. We're gonna get the key first, and then we're going to get the coins, because we're gonna need a bunch of those coins in order to buy abilities later on, which will help us complete the game a little bit quicker. So this is the other form of movement. I'm not really sure if it's faster than uppercuts. It's kind of confusing. They look very similar, and I've tried to time them, and I think the uppercuts are more consistent, so I continue to do those. Oh, okay, still got weird. There we go, the backup strat. So those other enemies you saw, the ones that shoot the bullets, those are Bianca abilities. They, you have to kind of just deflect their bullets using slow-mo in order to fight them, which is actually pretty convenient, because those slow-mo bullets do a lot of damage. So we'll be using a lot of projectiles in general over the course of the run. And I am just getting owned by these spiky little vines here. Alright, back this way. For those of you who are wondering, I'm playing the PS2 version. I don't really think there's any differences between GameCube and PS2, other than maybe loading times, but this game is run by IGT, not RTA. So. But I always run an RTA timer when I run this game, because it still lets you know how you're doing, how you're progressing in the run. Fives, I don't think I can hear you very well. This game's that loud. My what? Excuse me, Fives. Oh god. I'm having trouble with this heli. I'm supposed to diagonally kick some of these bullets towards it. There we go. That's better. Progress. Yeah, Beautiful Joe is probably one of the loudest games I've ever played in my life, actually. So there's the first boss down. That was kind of slow, but we got him. Right here, I'm going to be buying our first abilities, which are sliding. Or is sliding, I should say. That's going to eliminate the odd movement that I've been... Wait, did I forget to get boomerangs? Yes, I did. It's going to eliminate that strange movement that I'm doing with the uppercuts. It sounds a lot less silly and it's faster, so yay. Done with all that. So every single time you encounter Captain Blue, you end up learning a new ability of some sort. Obviously not one that you buy, but one that you just learn from Captain Blue. So we're going to encounter him again, and boomerangs are way powerful, like way too powerful. Here's a demonstration of how powerful boomerangs are in this game. I'm just going to take out Captain Blue with one fell swoop. Real easy. He's going to teach me how to go Mach speed. And I've become the supersonic dude. And now the speedrun gets pretty quick. Just go for it. Much quicker. With the combination of sliding and Mach speed, we are just going to start flying through this game. Up to open this door. Now the helicopter kind of serves as a boss fight, but I would say that this is the actual first boss fight of the game. Charles III, he's an evil big bat. Oh, oops. Let's try that again. There we go. Now boomerangs, again, very, very powerful. And Charles III is down. Yeah, that's the first boss. Let's get it on. And we'll be using a lot of boomerangs, and they come in handy against boss fights mainly. I won't be using many boomerangs during regular combat, like against regular enemies and whatnot. Get some Yaku abilities here. Another encounter with Captain Blue. This is an odd fight. There we go. Now we have Zoom In. Zoom In allows us to stun enemies, kind of just make them freeze. Zoom In is used mostly for damage, to be quite honest, but it does also help certain enemies, fighting certain enemies, because without Zoom In and slow-mo, some enemies in this game are just too strong to take care of quickly. Some quick platforming here. Something that's really cool about Zoom In is that we can actually use it for invincibility frames from these lasers. If you are in a spinning kick in Zoom In, you will not be touched by lasers. It's pretty cool. Helps you kind of get through certain parts of the game without getting damaged. all. Second Joker fight, which is pretty quick if you do that. It's a pretty intense strat. Just gotta wait for this V here. Where is it? There it is. There it is. Now we gotta get more coins as well. Perfect. Moving on. And by the way, this game is extremely fast-paced. World record is under 30 minutes. IGT, it's a little insane. Very, very well optimized by a guy named Teaminator. He's got a pretty cool tutorial on YouTube. It's very helpful if anybody ever wanted to try out some strats from this game. If this is one of your favorite GameCube games, which a lot of people, this is a favorite from a lot of people's childhoods when it comes to GameCube, so. Pick up some stuff from under this truck. Oh, I ran out of VFX stuff. There we go. Now this is something called a fast fuse. A fast fuse allows me to blow up shocking pinks instantly, and it allows me to take out helicopters so much more quickly. Those were two perfect fast fuses, so this was a pretty good example of how to do it. You go into mock speed, and as soon as the bomb comes out, you go into slow-mo. Now, the mock speed makes the bomb explode, initially as soon as you get it out. And then the slow-mo helps do the damage. So it's a pretty cool trick. It's actually all timing, so it's a lot harder than I just made it look, to be honest. To be quite honest with you. Now we're at the hotel, or what I assume is some type of hotel. Actually, not sure. I always say it's a hotel. Now we're going to do a very tricky jump here. Not first try. Second try? Hey, nice. Okay, this isn't working. There we go. So you're supposed to do a bunch of stuff before you can even get up to that spot, but that jump allows us to get to this area early. Now, the reason why Fast Fuse makes this run so much more quick is because we can do stuff like this. Oh, I fucked up. Hold on. We can break these without doing the intended way. The intended way is you're supposed to get these bombs that spawn for you, but why use the bombs that take, you know, a little while to spawn when you can just spawn a bomb instantly yourself? We get the key. Very nice. Bianco Billy's down. Oh. Now we have another Joker fight. pretty easy one, to be honest. Because he spawns right next to us. Which, it's basically free. He's just right there. Ready for the whopping. Let's go. Oh wait, we need coins. Let's get more coins. It's very easy to be impatient with the slot machines, but they're really important to be patient with, because you can lose a lot of time just sitting at the slot machine being frustrated. It's not landing on the things you want it to. This game was for GameCube and PS2. Move on. It came out on PS2 after the GameCube release, just because of how well it did in popularity. And also, the PS2 version has the music video at the end of the game, except it's in color. And it's got a cool... It's got, like, a couple extra scenes as well in it. Now, Hulk Davidson. Hulk Davidson is an awesome character. I love this guy. But we're gonna stunlock him. It's pretty embarrassing. He just kind of sits there and takes all of these boomerangs, and it's just over. It's just over.
Ready, Six Machine? Let's ride.
Now, if any of you have watched me run Beautiful Joe before, there's a section coming up here.
Let's get it on!
Where there will, not yet, after this auto-scrolling section, there's a part where I usually let my chat kind of just spam it up. I think I'm gonna give you guys permission to do that. So after this auto-scrolling is done, you will notice what the message is to spam. There's no way to speed this up. So we're gonna chill. Shoot some stuff up with the Six Machine. That's what our little ship is called, the Six Machine. It's neat stuff. That's not good. Better. Okay, so I got some pretty good RNG here. Or just some good luck, maybe I should say. These little missiles are actually gonna help me take this guy out real quick. So, like I said, projectiles can really come in use if you just use slow-mo. That's pretty nice. Okay, I'm also going to buy another power-up. It's a turbo... What was it called? The VFX turbocharger. So that VFX that I've been using to go into slow-mo and max speed and zoom in, it'll recharge about twice as fast now, so it actually really helps for certain platforming sections that are longer than, you know, many others. Like, there are a couple of sections in this game where there aren't many, like, checkpoints or things to kind of fall back on. so you just kind of have to deal with how much VFX you have, and you have to make good use of it. I don't think I have to remind anybody here that a bomb has been armed. I don't think I have to remind anyone. It seems like everyone found out pretty quickly that a bomb has indeed been armed. Now time for some of the worst slots. They're also the slots that are going to help stop this this intense spam in the chat here. Let me just save all of the lurkers. Hold on. I gotta disarm this bomb, man. Alright, the bomb's been disarmed. Well done, everyone. Good spam. That was good. Some good stuff. Now we're gonna fight Grand Bruce. Grand Bruce is probably one of my most favorite characters. If you ever get a chance to play this game, if you haven't yet, the voice acting is actually surprisingly good. There are some really, really funny bosses in this game. They're great. Got him. Oh wow, I'm actually ahead of PD at the moment. Just got 2 gold splits in a row. It's pretty cool. So a decent pace here. I'm gonna buy a power up really quickly because I always seem to forget it, which is Red Hawk Kick. No! Oh no! Please! No, please! There we go. Oh my gosh. That could have been very bad. There we go. So right there, I know it didn't seem like I did very much to skip anything, but I just skipped an entire level. I just did that level completely just different from what the game intends you to do, and I was able to skip all of it. Oh, where is this guy going? Hello, sir? Oh, there he is. Cool. Okay. Now time for platforming hell. I'm not very good at this platforming section. If you watch the world record, I mean, it is just insane how he does this. But I'll try and do my best here to complete it as quickly as I can. Just very precise jumping that I've already messed up. But I've already messed up pretty bad now. There we go. Oh, I almost got it. There we go. Out of here. I could have done that quicker, but... It's a very, very hard section, though. Now on to the next episode. Next episode. This one's interesting. Definitely one of the harder episodes in the entire game, just because it's long and some of the fights can be pretty tough. And there's also a pretty difficult section involving lava. You guys all know lava is not so great. Lava's bad for you. Everyone at home, don't play with lava. Good start. So, with that, I can probably take him out now. Yep. Great fast fuses here on the fighter jet. This fight was actually... I made that look a lot easier than it is. A lot easier. Oh, wrong way. This way. Hey. Alright, so mock speed in order to light ourselves on fire. Oh god, no! In the good way. In the good way, light ourselves on fire. God, if this would work though. I can save it. Oh, I can't save it. Hold on. Probably gonna die. Yep. Cut. That's okay though. This was the difficult section with lava I was talking about. Like I said, lava's bad. Lava's really bad. Oh, this game also doesn't want to zoom in. There we go. Okay. So what have we learned today at Voltathon Sparked? What have we learned today, everyone? Lava is bad for you, okay? Lava is bad for you. I'm just gonna fuck this up every single time, aren't I? Every time. Holy moly. Lava is not fast. As you can plainly see, I'm getting absolutely wrecked at this section. Because I am not doing the intended strats. Which I'm going to do now, because god, I am so sick of falling off. There we go. My gosh. Gonna die again, though. But this time I have a checkpoint. Yeah. I'm very happy to say though that this is probably the only bad thing that's happened in the run. There's a lot of really bad stuff that can happen in Beautiful Joe. So I'll take the lava. It's not that bad. Is that guy dead yet? No, he's not dead yet. Hello, sir? Please? Hello? Okay. Oh god, I can't do a fast fuse for whatever reason. There we go. Thank you. Okay, now we fight another jet. This jet's a lot easier than the one that I took out before. Simply because this one flies a little bit lower. So it's just easier to get on top of him. Like so. Another tank. And another fighter jet. So there's lots of intense fighting at this section. Oh, I didn't even hit him. Oh man, okay, that's fine. Got him. Nice. Alright, let's go. So after three fighter jets and two tanks and just so much going on, this level finally slows down a little bit. It doesn't slow down, but it gets a little bit easier. But that first part in the main city is just like, it's just so intense. Alright. So now I'm going to buy some more Shocking Pink, some more Voomerangs, and Mach Speed level 1.
Move on.
I love these enemies, because they just kind of funnel in from one direction. Like, they all spawn in the same spot, and none of them seem to notice that all of their friends are getting beat up by this pink dude. It's good stuff. It's good stuff. Oops, sir. I'm just waiting for the bomb to explode. There we go. That's what I wanted. Now this is one of the only times that I'm actually going to use Voomerangs on just normal enemies. It's really helpful for this section because you need to stay on this button in order to stop the train. And these guys just, they bother you a lot. Unless you somehow stun them. So I just throw boomerangs at him. Oh no, I bought level 2. Yes, I didn't buy level 1, I bought level 2. Sorry. So now we're just gonna bully Alistair. Alistair is actually from Devil May Cry. they decided to kind of just throw him in this game, which was, I thought was really cool. And he's dead. Easy peasy. Once again, boomerangs, very, very helpful against boss fights. Like Hulk Davidson and Alistair. Especially Alistair, because he flies up so high in the air and you can't really reach him without a boomerang, so very important. Move on to the boss rush. The boss rush is exactly how it sounds. It's a boss rush. We fight every single boss, and then a new one at the end of the boss rush. Oh, that's odd. That's odd as well. There we go. Wow, Teaminator is actually here. My gosh. Oh, oops. Give it up for this guy. He's actually the world record holder for Beautiful Joe. All categories. He is an absolute beast at this game. Oh, we're in trouble. Save. Oh, where did you go? There you are. Oops. Well, this got sloppy. I can save it, though. I can save it. There we go. Alistair. Or not Alistair, another Joe. Washed up at this point. Glad to see others playing. Dude, I really enjoy this run. I'm not gonna lie. Your tutorial helped me a lot. Your tutorial helped me a ton, dude. Got him. Alright. Should probably buy some stuff while I'm here. Mach speed, level 3. We're gonna need that, so let's just get that real quick. Easy peas.
Move on.
And then Fire Leo. This guy is insane. I don't do a quick strat for this fight at all. I actually take my time. Just because he's actually that difficult to kind of come back from. Once you've made a mistake against Fire Leo, it's hard to come back from that. Oh god, there we go. That was all really, really bad. He kept on giving me low attacks, and I died. Anyways, you want the high attack. You don't want the low attack, because then you can keep on uppercutting him. Which I was trying to do that, but I was kind of just messing up. Like I said, once you mess up against Fire Leo, it's pretty hard to come back from it. There we go. get some uppercuts in. Hope for some upper attack. Keep on doing the up attacks, please, Fire Leo. Oh, shit. Oh, well. Oh boy. This is a pretty messy fight. Pretty messy. Oh, he's down. Alright. Throw a bomb. Finally. Very, very sloppy Fire Leo. That's alright. It's done and over with. We can go to one of the cooler levels in the game. Kind of the futuristic, almost Star Wars-esque level. With some interesting new enemies based on Fire Leo. Oh god, hit already. Oh, you're shitting me. Oh no. Hey, there we go. Oh, that's unfortunate. Oh man. All right, I missed the platform as well. Oh boy. Dan, I don't even want to picture that. All right, screw that room. That room Kind of an awkward one. You're practically relying on these odd platform-ish enemies to get up to where you need to be, so. Darn you, platformers. Yeah, this is actually the only platformer I run. It's definitely a cool experience, though. Learning this game. So here are those enemies that are based on Fire Leo. Mainly using Red Hawk kicks against them. Oh, I jumped at the wrong time. That sucks. That sucks a lot.
Ready, action!
Well, let's try that again, shall we? All right. So, Another little intermission screen here. I'm gonna buy boomerangs just because I can, and I feel like I've used a lot in this run. I might not have enough towards the end. Just playing it safe. An awkward fight. There we go. Oh, he's doing the iframe thing. I'm not really sure why he has iframes during that attack. It seems a little fishy. There we go. Now, the difference between these slots and all of the other slots is that these, you actually need to go into mock speed in order to complete. That was kind of risky. Okay. Oh, there we go. Okay, I don't understand this part. Every single time I run this game, on my own channel, like, I don't explain this because I don't know how it works. It doesn't make any sense, but I'm going to initially punch the shit out of this bomb and, in turn, make all of these missiles destroy these battleships. You know what? That is kind of just the essence of Beautiful Joe. Nothing really makes that much sense, but we do it, and it works. This was a pretty experimental title. Clover hadn't even been around for very long. Just turned out to be a really great speed game. Because it's got so much interesting tech. Based on the way that they just made the game, really. Wait a second. Oh, yeah, there's the key. I need that. Where did this Bianco Billy go? Where are you going, sir? get some health real quick, because I need that. I'm gonna die in here. Wait, where are the other guys? Hello? Did these guys not spawn? Excuse me? Hi! Welcome to Beautiful Joe, enemies that were supposed to spawn like 10 minutes ago. Hey, alright. Pretty big exaggeration there. Anyways. Fire Leos. Oh, not yet. These guys first, then Fire Leos. Oh, what? Well, that's okay. To be honest, my estimate is pretty healthy for this game. So, nothing to really worry about. That works. Now the Fire Leos. And we're gonna take them out like the other ones. Just red hot kicks. What is this guy doing? Sir, hello? Hello? This guy. Oh, I've never seen this before. What am I supposed to do? He's just dancing up there, man. Hey! So these are the final two bosses. I don't really need anything.
Move on.
Shoutouts to Metal Leos. Those cyborg Leos. Now we're just gonna boomerang. The faster you can do these boomerangs, the better, but we're doing pretty decent. Nice. I've messed this up. Luckily, No. Alright. And that is Beautiful Joe. 90% kids. About 55 minutes. Let these juicy credits roll. But yeah, thank you guys for having me. Showing off some Beautiful Joe. It was good fun. And Voltathon sparked. Still going. Lots of really, really good runs over the next couple of days. So thank you guys for your support already today. It's been pretty awesome. Much love and thank you. And I'll probably see you tonight? 5 in the morning? PST. 8 a.m. EST for Jet Set Radio. So I'll see you guys then.